Our final game of the day on pitch two, Peru and Egypt women. Now both these sides are going to finish third and fourth in the group that they are in, Group A. So it won't be good enough, unfortunately, to progress. Top tier competition out of their reach. So they're looking to finish the group on a high. Missing a valiant effort from the Peru men's team, who will still be in the competition knockout phase in the tier two competition. The two competitions up for grabs. These two are in the top end of the draw. Tough group with Mexico and Colombia. Okay, a pair of them trainers. They look cool. We're underway anyway. Peru do have a lot of goals in them. Just, it's been, as I say, a tough group really to get out of. And one last go at enjoying this party for day four. Thanks for joining us, however long you've been with us, if it's been all day or if it's just been for this game in particular. It's great to have you on board. Use the hashtag, follow the website, follow the social media, keep in touch with us at the Homeless World Cup. Day four almost at a conclusion, the final game in pitch two. Not long left as it's getting towards the end of the afternoon in Mexico City. It is after 5 o'clock now. Start at 9 a.m. It's been another busy, busy day. Mona. It's been a party atmosphere again in Mexico City's Ocala Square. The cars are going by, the people are walking out, people are sitting around enjoying the football. Whatever pitch it's been on, there have been three pitches of action, 76 games. Today alone, there's over 360 across the week of competition, just under a week of competition. Egypt in those navy colours. Mona Rifat is now picking up the ball. Oh, it's a good goal, near post finish. And it's Egypt who take the lead here. Chance again there for the opening scorer, Amil Hussein. This time taken. I think that in goal for Peru is Carmen Mosquipa today, for this game anyway. And it's Egypt continuing to possession the first 3 minutes. Mona Rifat. Rifat, bounce off Puma, off the board. I think Mosquito are taking a bit of a hit. She'll have to go off here. They do have two goalkeepers. Karen Luna comes on. Hopefully nothing too serious injury-wise. Peruvians watch on. I'm sure the men's team will be watching on. Once they've cooled down from the game they've just played. And that was an opportunity and a half for Peru to get themselves back in level terms with Valenas on the far side. Egyptian ball in the corner area. Rifat. There's a lot of shoves going on there. Amel Hussein. Play on here. Ball coming in the first time from Derek Valenias. More contact in the middle of the park. Play on. Eventually, Mona Rifat gets there, trying to take it off Judith Vargas. Valenias just slides it in here. And the referee's whistle goes. Well, hoisted down. Bit scrappy here from both sides. Few meaty little feet going in and challenges going in. Puma's shot was fairly weak for Yasmin Alderedi. Stolen here. Sara Lotfi. Only briefly though as Valenas gets it back. Now Vargas. And the header's fallen up and in for Peru. However, Rifat up the other side nearly got in with a quick delivery. Vargas, a bit loose there for Puma. Oh, it's a good effort to hand the thing away. Here's Vargas at the other side. I think I'm sure I've already got her hand onto it. And it's going to creep in here for Egypt. And the second goal coming from Sara Lotfi. Hussein, half time. And Egypt taking the lead just at the end of that first half again, which means Peru have got a little pyramid to climb in the second half to get back into this. But it is 2-1 here at the break in this final game of the day in Mexico City. Little breezy in Mexico City as second half action of the final game here on pitch 2 today. Peru and Egypt women, and Hussein with an early chance for the Egyptians. Music is blaring, the party continues. I'm sure it will continue beyond this last game. Hussein again, but another wonderful day in Mexico City here. are Peru back in possession. Olivares now on number six, as is Iwalakta. Two further scorers for the Peruvians looking to finish the high. There's nothing really extensively to play for in terms of the top tier, in terms of the competition that they're trying to make by finishing the top two. Oh, it's a good save away by Adoride, but 3 points and a win. These sides both won four games, the conventional way anyway, in the main group phase that they had. It's just such a tough format, this second phase with four teams, and it's strong teams as well. There's an injury here, so a stoppage in play. Hashtag Mexico2018, we see the conversation. And remember to check out the website for the articles and features and tables and stories. Everything is on there. I'm sure if you're watching the coverage, you're well aware of the social media coverage. Looks like a bit of an injury for Hussein, Amels Hussein, so she's going to be replaced. She gingerly walks off. Monarifat, and sub in there is Dalia Sheriff. It's a close, edgy old game this, not too happy. Conceding the foul, Iwalakta, she thought she was okay. Lacta wrestling away. This real pitch side coming, gives you a right feel of the action. Cross it comes to Lacta. And oh, came off, I think, through the keeper's legs and off the board, just kept it behind. Another referee whistle going here. In fact, was she outside the box, was she? A penalty's been signalled. I think one or two, not sure why. Couldn't really see from the angle. Anyway, Peru have a chance to equalise here. It's too high though from Judith Vargas. It remains 2-1 to Egypt, 3 minutes into the second half. Sandra Olivares, and now coming away, Lotfi. Dalia Sheriff down in that corner again. Good old tussle this, and the Egyptians won the ball. And here's Lotfi. Lotfi again, surely! 3-1 Egypt. Mona Rifat. And Egypt will claim 3 points in this group. Unless there is a final save from Peru. Olivares stopped by Sheriff. Already are nicknamed Soka. Free kick here. Cross this comes here Olivares. Not quite. Peru running out of time here. Need two goals at least. Looks like Egypt will pick up 3 points to close off the group. Olivares cushioning them back. Peru need a goal now. Stasi for Valenias. Olivares dispossessed. Daniel Sheriff stopped in their tracks. Well, to the final minute now. Rifat. Stasi. And in it goes. In the final seconds, Sandra Olivares, 3-2. There's literally about 15, 20 seconds left in the clock. Oh, a bit of crap kicking in. Wonder if I'm going to keep this down that side. Final chance here for Peru. Olivares waiting. Play on here, says the referee. Olivares. Wheels away, Olivares! And again, it's held. And despite the late pressure from Peru, it will be the 3 points and the closer of the group. Well, these two won't finish in the top two. It will be Egypt to take it. In the most harem scarem closing few seconds. They had it fairly comfortable when they went 3-1 up, but Peru made it a bit scary towards the end. But hugs all round with the final score of Peru 2, Egypt 3. Well, here's some of the best bits from the game. This brings to an end our coverage here. There's still one game on pitch 1, so do check that out. But 25 games in pitch 2, the same number in pitch 3, 26 in pitch 1. 76 games. It's been another mammoth day, moving day ahead of the knockout phase tomorrow. Coverage of pitch 1 and pitch 2 you can see on the Homeless World Cup social media channel, so do check that out tomorrow. From a mammoth day which has taken over 8 and a bit hours, it has been fun, it's been thrilling, the entertainment's been there, the carnival's been there again. We look forward to it again on Saturday morning. We get underway once more from 9 a.m. from all the team covering the action from Mexico City. We see the scenes. It's goodbye from us.